Volume 3, Episode 2 of The League of Extremely Ordinary Gentlemen.
When you hear the ping, please turn to the next frame in your film strip.
Big score. I was cleaning out my... That reminds me. I was cleaning out my garage the other day.
And you found some power records. I want dibs on the Captain America and the Falcon.
Not quite that cool, but damn, I did find the tape of Roscoe Lee Brown narrating the story of Star Wars with actual clips.
Oh, right on.
From the film and everything.
That's weird. I was just thinking about Roscoe Lee Brown yesterday.
And at the sound of R2-D2.
Kids, get on Wikipedia and look for Roscoe Lee Brown.
Oh, it's great. It is so good.
That's that was a weird way for us to start, but okay.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. They're doing a show, huh?
Bo triggered a random memory, and, you know, there you go.
See, I told you we should have done a shot first.
We would like to proudly announce that we have been bought out by the Disney Corporation. There will be no more profanity. We will not be drinking anything other than apple juice, and instead of Long Live the League, we will now conclude our episodes with a nice sing-song.
Of When You Wish Upon a Star.
We're a small world, after all, and you're... pigeon nation that we're not really thinking
it's
about.
A small world after all, because Disney has bought everything and it is now controlled by their corporate headquarters.
Yes. Next summer you will be able to visit the Leog Kingdom. It's mostly a bunch of cigarette butts, busted beer bottles, and torn trade paperbacks.
Don't bring your children.
Don't bring
yeah,
them.
Yeah, it would be
don't
pretty
let
much...
them dig anywhere. I'm just saying.
It'd be itchy and scratchy land.
Right.
That's truly a terrifying
thought.
Bow
is the scariest thing you'll ever see.
Yeah, there's going to be a different land for each of us.
It's like in Westworld, but it's the Greek world. Where you go see Bo and he's wearing a toga and he's got a catamite with him.
So have you ever seen Caligula?
Right.
And the robot Jason comes up wanting to fight you.
Yeah. Put up your dukes.
Actually, Jason Land is just a room full of whiskey.
Right.
It's like all the rides in the world in one land.
So I don't know. This Disney buyout of Leog doesn't sound so bad the way y'all are putting it.
Yeah, I'm kind of digging it.
And that's all we're saying. Disney is smart enough to know how to brand their corporations and work with it.
That's true. And generally speaking, I do agree with you. Although I will be discussing some dissonance on that as we go along. I don't necessarily agree with it, but there are certainly those who aren't just screaming and like, you know, the sky is falling. Smart people who are saying, look, this isn't all bright good news. I'll bring that up later. We are, of course, talking about really Disney's buyout of Marvel.
Is that the theme for today? Or we have multiple themes?
We have multiple themes today.
Such as?
We hope to stretch out for as long as possible.
Yeah, because we always have a trouble stretching.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to talk about Disney's buyout of Marvel. We're going to talk about the two big events going on in the two big comic companies, DC and Marvel. DC's Blackest Night and Marvel's Dark Reign.
Man, but these two guys just cannot stop copying off of each other.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about
it. It's Twister and Tornado, Armageddon and Impact.
Yeah, it's Volcano and Dante's Peak.
And then we're going to talk about fish. Anyway, we're going to...
hey, man.
Then we're going to give fish his last wedgie as a high school student.
I'm going to miss him.
Of course, we're all going to miss him.
Yeah.
It'll be hard to tell he's not here because he never says anything anyway.
Is he the one with the glasses or the one with the goatee?
We're actually just stealing your stuff and putting it on eBay. That's what's getting me through college.
We're just going to take a picture of you and make a cardboard cutout and have it put it next to a mic every time until November.
Man, so. You guys need to chill because when he comes back, he's going to own all
that's
those.
True. He's so good at the art already without even having gone to college. It's like he's going to come back and like own Marvel Comics. He'll own Disney.
Yeah. I mean, you know what happened when some people go to college, though? They fucking squander it on weed, booze, and whores.
Woo! That's ridiculous.
Oh, I want to go.
That sounds squandering.
Yeah.
Well, that's life experience, my friend.
That's called getting it out of your system.
Fish is going to come back with a mighty portfolio, and he's going to come sit here on top of his portfolio and still not say anything.
Okay. No,
and he's going to have white boy dreads. And yeah.
Jason makes a good point.
My
though.
Name is now Ross Fish. Are you better, John?
Jason makes a very good point, though. Now, you can go to college, Jason Fish, and you can get an education. You can pay attention in class, or you can not look back with regret at the end of your life. So it's really your choice.
I'm going to try to remember as little about college as possible.
Just watch Van Wilder several times before you go.
Well, actually, maybe not Van Wilder.
Right,
not
Van Wilder.
Go with Animal House.
No, okay. Van Wilder.
What?
He had it down. He was like Bugs Bunny, always getting away with shit, smarmy about it.
Yeah, but Bugs Bunny is funny.
Van Wilder was awesome.
Hey, man, Ryan Reynolds, come on.
Deadpool, oh, yeah.
Ryan Reynolds is one of those actors that I find my whole life perpetually forgiving. You know? He's like, he's a family member or something. You're like, oh, Ryan.
He's like Brendan Fraser. I mean, he, you can't act, but I like you anyway.
The guy married your number one lady. You still can't get mad at him.
No, I know. No matter what he does, you know, he doesn't get on the air and say, man, you know what? The only reason I ever go on Spills to listen to a Coco, everything else sucks. Yeah. I'd be like, oh, Ryan.
keep kissing his ass, Cyrus.
Please take off your shirt.
Okay. Oh, you won't have to tell him to take off his shirt. It's always off anyway.
He's got that McConaughey gene.
Yeah, McConaughey's going, man, settle down. Not yet.
Yeah, they both, there's you know, some store in L.A.
You gotta wait for the precise moment to go up to the director and say, you know, I think now it's a good time for me to take off my shirt.
There's some store in L.A. that has shirts with Velcro fasteners down the side for just for those two guys.
Yeah. Oh, those stores are all over, actually.
That's a horrifying thought, Bo. Don't ever say that again.
He's wearing one now.
But let's, you know, obviously the Fish thing, we're going to say goodbye to Fish. He's heading off to college.
Let's just do
Holy
it now.
Shit.
Goodbye. Bye-bye.
You guys just wait. You remember what a little douche Luke Skywalker was in the first Star Wars? Or what a badass he was by Return of the Jedi?
Besides, I'll make my own podcast.
Leon just called you a douche.
Besides, we can't do it first because the mail stripper doesn't get here for another hour.
Oh, right.
So, shit, did I say that out loud? Oh, crap.
Well, if he doesn't show
that's
up,
why
well,
Bo is wearing the that's why Bo's wearing the Velcro secured shirt.
Get ready to rock and roll, pal.
Hot cops.
Ooh, there's some handcuffs. Has somebody been naughty?
Wow, I thought I was disturbed before. Anyway, Disney and Marvel. Disney and Marvel. La 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 la, Disney and Marvel.
Just
wow.
Concentrate on the taste of vomit in your mouth.
Let's all sound off.
Well, yeah. Okay, I thought everybody, it's volume 3. Who doesn't know us by now?
Hey, man.
Maybe new listeners?
Let's hope we're getting new listeners.
That's true.
I mean, for fuck's sake.
As the one female voice is confused with the other female voices, I think we should sound off.
Okay, fair enough. This is Cyrus.
And Leon, the co-pilot.
I'm Bo.
Jason.
Grant.
Fish.
Randy.
Kristen.
Yay. And the cat.
I am Ricardo Montalban, your host.
And this is Leog. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Guess what?
Let's Leog this!
volume 3.
The saga continues!
Volume 3 still don't have a theme song.
Yeah. Well, we
don't even have a musician, so why should we bother with
Well,
that?
That's because Greg
heard
actually,
the melody for it.
Yeah, Greg would never have gotten where he is today without us. So,
yeah, that's,
you know.
That's true.
I'm just waiting for him to tell his fancy pants band, I'm sorry, we can't play tonight. I've got a Leog.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's keep waiting for that to happen.
I have to pass up this paying gig.
Yeah, right. And then someday, Leog will pay. Okay, probably not.
Seriously. Right? Oh, God.
What just happened there?
I lost the capacity to speak. I never thought that would happen to me.
That would be a good spot for canned laughter, by the way.
But, okay, so let's go right into this Disney Marvel thing.
Which, by the time you hear this, it's already old.
And you were like, oh, God, Jesus Christ, are people still talking about this?
Yeah, that's bullshit.
However, it's only because I get requests every day for my opinion on this. On this huge merger, which actually puts no money in my pocket whatsoever.
Oh, right. Good for you.
Marvel managed to pay $4 billion for 5,000 characters, which means they have...
You mean Disney managed
Disney.
To pay.
Oh, yeah, Disney. And that means they have 4,950 shitty Marvel characters.
So you don't think we're going to see a Blonde Phantom movie or...
I think we are going to see a Typeface movie, though.
Ooh,
yeah. No, you guys aren't looking at the real potential.
I want...
Think about it. A 3D man movie in 3D.
Hey.
Am I finally going to get that Ancor the Screamer movie that I've been dreaming about?
The Aquarian.
Yes! I know that generally speaking, we joke about this, but none of us really think that, like, okay, we're going to be seeing, like, you know, Spider-Man suddenly fighting, you know, Donald Duck or something, Uncle Scrooge or something like that.
Both of those guys could use a good ass whooping.
Although I'm sure it'll happen in the world of video games. I have no doubt
Kingdom
that we
Hearts.
Will see a Kingdom Hearts where suddenly all the
absolutely.
Marvel characters are in it. But as far as, like, movies and cartoons and stuff like that, I seriously doubt we're going to see anything like
I
that happen.
I think
happening.
We'll see some kids' comics at some point that cross the characters over in a Kingdom Hearts style. But it'll probably be an adaptation of the Kingdom Hearts video or the video game with the Marvel characters.
Right, yeah. And at this point, you're not bothered by Tiny Titans and Spider-Man.
Yeah. Well, I would...
I would disagree just because, I mean... DC is owned by Warner Brothers, and you don't see any crossovers with Bugs Bunny and Batman.
Actually, you do.
I was just gonna bring up the Duck Dodgers Green Lantern episode. Yeah, Daffy Duck became a Green Lantern.
But here's the thing: they are out of continuity, so don't sweat it. I mean,
I don't really care.
Spider-Man used to be on the fucking Electric Company. Don't worry about it.
Spider-Man is not gonna make a deal with Mephisto and marry Minnie Mouse. It's not gonna happen. Well, with Quesada in charge, it might. You never know.
And to be fair, when you said Duck Dodgers becomes a Green Lantern, I was like all over that.
it was actually kind of cool. I mean, you know, in the realm, in as much as it was Daffy Duck becoming a Green Lantern in his own cartoon, rather than the Green Lantern cartoon where they inducted Daffy Duck as a Green Lantern.
I'm going to tell you right now, Frank Castle's going to clean up the Magic Kingdom.
But if I may play Mephisto's advocate, Disney is a lot more hands-on than Warner Brothers is. I mean, Warner Brothers has always been so fragmented. And they're like, look, we're making money. Just do a couple of things we need, and everything's cool. Whereas Disney's more of a micromanager.
It depends, though. I mean, look at what they've done to Miramax. Nothing. They pretty much left them alone to their own devices.
And that's the deal that they have. But you're saying like the deal they have with an independent film company where there's no real branding.
On the other hand, the same deal
they're going to have with a major license.
On the other hand, they took ABC and changed it to a much more family-oriented type of a network. Not completely, of course. They've still got shows like Lost and stuff on there, but
The big thing is Disney paid $4 billion for a company that was working. I'm not saying corporations don't do stupid things, because they do, but they'd be idiots to come in and be, okay, we paid $4 billion for this that was working. Let's change everything.
Well, that's the one thing I got to say. Yeah. I'll hand it to Joe Quesada on, because 10 years ago,
that company
wasn't worth anywhere near that much money.
No. Yeah. That's the first thing I thought. Is like, this totally legitimizes his reign, because whatever we might say about
his dark reign.
I'm just waiting for the heads of Disney to sit there and say, okay, so what's going on with Marvel? So your number one character made a deal with Satan. I've made a huge mistake.
Actually, to break your heart a little, Jason, the guy who divorced Spidey and Mary Jane just made a lot of money this week.
Yes, he did.
It's his fault. But the big
upside... your Avengers are all serial killers now? What is happening?
Yeah. But the big upside, Pixar.
Pixar Spider-Man movie.
There's already talk of Pixar possibly animating one of the Marvel characters in a movie. I'm like, you know what? I don't have a problem with that. It's Pixar. If John Lasseter, who was given absolute final word over their animation division, like nobody at Disney is even allowed to question his judgment on stuff. If he says, you know what, I've got a great idea how I can do a Pixar adaptation of a Marvel character, then I'm going to believe him. And they have actually been talking about doing an adult animated film for like 6-7 years now. Right. They were talking about John Carter of Mars for a while.
Yes, they
were.
They've already done it. Because The Incredibles was clearly the Fantastic Four.
You know what? I'm sorry. This might seem like heresy, but Pixar's not the most fucking original studio around. Okay? I mean, you got The Incredibles as Fantastic Four. Cars as Doc Hollywood. True. Wall-E looks just like Johnny Five.
You
know.
Well, they borrow heavily from other sources.
Monsters, Inc. is Little Monsters.
Oh, no.
Finding Nemo is
Forget Little Monsters.
Name.
It was a Nickelodeon cartoon called Monsters. And it's the exact same goddamn concept. And I can't believe nobody ever brings that up.
You know, what I always say, though, is like, okay, that's fine. But they made top-notch 5-star movies.
Oh, they did.
So
yeah.
Who gives a shit?
Yeah, exactly.
Would you rather watch Doc Hollywood or Cars?
Yeah, exactly.
And whenever anybody gets to...
I'd actually rather Doc Hollywood.
Would you rather watch Fantastic Four or The Incredibles?
you got me there. Whenever anybody gets too big into the, like, well, that idea isn't original, I'm just like, yeah, well, neither was anything that William Shakespeare wrote, so shut up.
Yeah, no. I mean, the history of art is the history of stealing, that's for sure. It's all in the way you do it. Everyone who accuses Tarantino so much of stealing, it's like, well, look, man, he's hardly the first. He's just one of the first to wear it on his sleeve to go, look, I'm stealing from my influence.
Yeah, I'm weaving all these things, all these different things into something new. I love that guy who made the documentary all about Reservoir Dogs, how he compared it to the City on Fire.
Who do you think you're fooling?
Yeah, who do you think
Ringo
you're fooling?
Ringo Lam, City on Fire.
Okay, and that was one that was like, wow, he totally, stole that.
And they got him in there denying it.
Yeah. And that was cool. Then when the guy did it with Pulp Fiction, citing all these different references, it's like, dude, all the energy you're putting in it.